Hare Krishna. As long as we are bound by desire, we will be bound to fear. Suppose somebody is an alcoholic and they have kept, now their family members, relatives don't approve the alcoholism. So they have kept some alcohol hidden somewhere. Nah, or they have kept some money secretly somewhere so that they can buy an alcohol. They kept a secret account from which they withdraw, nobody comes to know. Then they will constantly be in fear. Oh, what if somebody detects that I bought this alcohol? Oh, so what if somebody detects that I'm spending this money? So when we have an unhealthy desire, that desire makes us dependent on something outside of us. And as long as we are dependent on something outside of us, we are bound to have fear. So things outside of us are not in our control. To the extent we strive to control them, to that extent we expend our energy, and sometimes despite the utmost expenditure of our energy, still things out of control just veer out of control. They don't come in our control. So people often seek money for security. And yes, money does bring some security. But then money itself becomes the cause of anxiety. We invest our money in some stocks, and what if the stocks crash? We keep some money somewhere, what if it's stolen? So there is great anxiety in these situations. So what we need to do is recognize that we need inner security. The Bhagavad Gita says that external security simply causes insecurity, anxiety. Chintam aparimeyam cha pralayantam upashritaha kamopabhoga parama etavaditi nishchitaha. In 16.11 it states that chintam aparimeyam cha, there is unlimited anxiety. Pralayantam upashritaha, that till the moment of death. Why? Kamopabhoga parama. Because we have made the conclusion that sensual pleasure is the supreme purpose of life. Etavad iti nishchitaha. This is what we are seeking. This is what we have ascertained. So as long as we think the sensual pleasures out there are the goal of life, and they are the supreme purpose of life, then we are bound to anxiety, which is unending and which is ever expanding. So, of course, we cannot give up desire entirely. But what we can do is redirect desire. We can channel the power of desire so that it takes us towards Krishna, so that it enables us to attain Krishna. When that happens, then there is supreme fulfillment. Then there is the opportunity, because the Lord is always with us, within us. So the desire for Him does not cause any fear because He is with us always. In fact, the desire for Him brings a supreme fearlessness, because then we are with the being who can grant us a supreme security. So thus, desiring of the world brings anxiety, binds us to fear. But desiring the Lord of the world frees us from fear. Thank you. Hare Krishna.